Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Warm greetings from our JRIF Cell Celebration at Calgary, Alberta. Thank you for joining us. This is our Sunday Cell Life Celebration. So our message today is about God's rescue mission. And this is a new series that we want to explore for a few Sundays leading up to God's great commission written in Matthew 28, verses 19 to 20. We want to welcome everyone, our Bishop Arnold Magtibay and Pastora Edith, all the way to Pangasinan. Thank you for lending us those praise and worship videos of our Pangasinan youth. So today, we're gonna go to our topic of what we call God's rescue mission. God's rescue mission. So the central theme of the Bible is about God Himself. God Himself. And God, who is the sovereign creator and Lord of the universe, is rescuing His people in the person of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Why rescue? Saan po tayo kailangan iligtas ng Diyos? What happened during the Genesis time? So the Bible will show us the series of events in the way that God rescues and redeems His creation from Genesis to Revelation. And we find in Genesis chapter 1, God creating the heavens and the earth in 6 days. We find in Genesis chapter 2, the more focused picture of God making man, and then God instituted marriage between man and woman. And after that, God rested. God rested not because He's tired, but because God had finished His work. But then right after the Genesis 2, comes to Genesis 3, we find the serpent tempted the man and the woman. And that led them to the fall of them, or the fall of man into sin. So the events went downward so fast because of sin. And then if we look at Genesis chapter 3, verses 14 to 15, this would be the thesis, the statement of the whole Bible regarding God's rescue mission. Dahil ang nangyari po, nahulog sa kasalanan ang mga tao, He needs to rescue. He needs to bring back what man has lost. So in Genesis chapter 3, verse 14, this is what God mentioned about the serpent. So the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you are cursed. Sinumpa ng Diyos ang serpent because of what he did to the people. More than all cattle and more than every beast of the field, on your belly you shall go. Dati po, ano? According to them, ang ahas, ang serpent, may paa, apat na paa. But then when God cursed the serpent, you know, gumagapang na lang siya. You shall eat dust. And what is dust? That's human. No? The food of the serpent, the food of Satan, of the devil, are the people who rejected Christ. That's why he eats dust all the days of his life. The next verse says, I will put enmity between you and the woman. Enmity means a coalition, a collision. Yeah? Nagbabanggaan silang dalawa, between the serpent and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. It is not the woman per se ang babangga sa kay Satanas, but the seed that is in her. We know that woman has no seed, but then somebody needs to supply that seed to the woman. And what will happen? He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. So from then on, as God says, I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed, yeah, and you will bruise him on the heel, and he will bruise your head. The rest of the scripture, the rest of the Bible, is the outworking of the rescue mission of our Lord Jesus Christ. God has given his son this rescue mission, or what we call the redemptive plan. The rescue mission of God started since Genesis time and onwards until the promised seed comes. And it says here, the promised seed that will bruise the head of the serpent, Satan. So yung pong seed, the seed, na manggagaling sa babae, manggagaling sa Diyos at lalabas sa babae, ang siyang magbubruise or magbubruise ng ulo ng demonyo. That means ito ang siyang sisira at magwawakas sa plano ng kaaway sa tao. So we look forward to the coming of that person and the work of our Lord Jesus Christ as we see the finished work of our Lord on the cross. Dumating na po yung Messiah, dumating na yung seed. At natapos na po yung plano ng Diyos na i-rescue ang mga tao. But then, we need to anticipate the completion of this rescue mission as the Lord plan and it is set up according to Revelation of His second coming and we wait on it anxiously. No? Inihintay po natin ito. No? So God is rescuing His people. So the promised seed is God rescuing His people in the person of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Tayo po ang inililigtas ng Diyos through His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And yet, you know what? Ang nakakalungkot po, ang concern po natin, we treat the Bible as though the redemptive story is just a minor thing. We come to our daily daily way that we treat the Bible as though this redemption is only a minor idea of God. No? As though the redemption is something that we see only in New Testament. No? At marami nga pong ika nga lumalabas na arguments about how God performs this rescue mission on behalf of the believers. Somehow, ang tingin ng mga tao, maging ng mga believers, that the rescue plan of God is kind of changing. And it's not as what we see in the scripture. Ano pong ibig sabihin nito? Tandaan po natin, we cannot change the nature of the rescuer who is God. Changing the nature of the rescuer would change the rescue plan itself. No? Ano pong ibig sabihin nito? Marami pong tao, they made their own way to rescue their own selves instead of God rescuing them. Instead of the redemptive plan of God set up for people to come back to Him, nagkaroon ng own idea ang tao. Like a man-made religion, as we learned before. The man-made belief. Oh, mabait naman ang Diyos. Hindi ako paparusahan ng Diyos kasi tumutulong naman ako sa kapwa ko, nagpapaaral ako ng mga pabangking ko, and I'm sending money and balikbayang boxes in my family. Mabait naman ako, hindi naman ako puro bisyo. No? That's a man-made religion. No one can be saved, can be rescued in his life unless you surrender to God. Because the only rescue plan, the only redemptive plan that God has set up is redemption through His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Ang kaligtasan po ay sa Panginoong Jesus lamang matatagpuan. ultimately people are would say, why, you know, I don't need that. I don't need religion. Yes, we don't need religion. I don't need these arguments about the rescue plan of God. I just want peace to myself. No? Yung iba, lalayo na lang. No? Gusto ko ako lang, tahimik lang ako. At wala akong ibang iniistorbo. Alam ng Diyos kung anong nasa puso ko. No? Ganon ang mindset ng tao. They think that they can do it alone. No? You know, the devil is so crafty. No? Kahit yung mga Kristiyano na tinasabing matatag, ay nahuhulog pa sa patibong ng kaaway. So, we need the church. We need a cell group. We need people, believers, that are coming together even on digital platform. Napaka-simple na po ng ginagawa natin ngayon. At the convenience of your home, we can discuss, we can share the love of God with one another. Ano pa ang ibang tao? Yung iba, they plan to, sabi nila, they need therapy. What I only need is therapy. No? What I only need is peace in the world. No? What I only need is social justice. No? And I really need is to be educated. I need information. I need certification and so on. No, they think that those are the keys or as the answers to their greatest problem. And people are sometimes, you know, when they reject Christ, when they reject the redemptive plan of God, you know, they change the way they look at God. They change the way they look at man. They change the way they look at the scripture. All of the sudden, ang Biblia po ay nawalan na ng halaga sa tao. You know? At alam nyo, as we learned last week, we need to be fed by the Word of God, which is the Bible. We need that. Okay? We need that. So God is the rescuer who brings about this rescue that He pronounces through bringing the promised seed and crushing the head of the serpent. But somehow now, God being the rescuer, you know, although we are informed that the saving power is through our Lord Jesus Christ, but you know, the dealings we do with the Word of God is just but so minimal. Parang hindi main point ang pagbabasa ng salita ng Diyos sa atin. But look at this. Look at this. In Luke 24, we will see how important the Word of God is. We will see in Luke 24, starting verse 13, here is a story of two disciples walking on the road to Emmaus. And, you know, as they discuss things about what happened in Jerusalem, Jesus is finally revealing himself to this man on the road to Emmaus. Napakaganda hong pakinggan ito. Talagang on the road to Emmaus, these two disciples were discussing about what happened a few days ago. No? And they got the most profound questions and of all the verses in the Bible. The two disciples were kept from recognizing our Lord Jesus Christ as He went with them, walking, going to Emmaus. And they were talking to Jesus that they do not know that it was Jesus. And he asked about what's been going on. No? Tinanong sila ni Lord, ano ba ang nangyayari? Ano ba pinag-uusapan nyo? Alam nyo, si Cleopas, yung isa sa mga disciple, look at him and they say, are you the only stranger in Jerusalem? And have you not known the things which happened there in these days? Ikaw ba ay hindi taga dito at hindi mo alam kung ano mga nangyari sa mga nakaraang araw? No? Sinasabi niya kay Lord. Although, you know, the Bible says hindi nila na-recognize si Lord. No? Alam niyo, our Lord Jesus Christ can say, you know, I'm the only one who knew what's going on. No? But he didn't say that. He didn't say that. Instead, in this verse, in next slides, in Luke 24, verses 25 to 27, Jesus said to them, O foolish ones, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets had spoken. Napakahina naman ng mga kokote nyo. Napakahina naman at napakabagal ng inyong pananampalataya, no? Pagtitiwala, no? All the prophets have spoken. Kung ano yung nakasulat sa na isinulat ng mga propeta, which is the Old Testament. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter to His glory? No? Ayun na, sinisimula na ni Lord na explain it to them. And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, He interpreted to them in all the scriptures things concerning Himself. That means our Lord Jesus, beginning with Moses, that means the Pentateuch, the first five books of the Bible, yeah? And all the prophets, even those written by prophets and all the rest of the Old Testament, no? He interpreted it to them in all the scriptures concerning our Lord Jesus Christ. And that is why the central theme of the Bible is Himself, our Lord Jesus Christ. No? He says, you should have understood it. Dapat naintindihan nyo dahil you have the Old Testament. Kasi wala pa hong New Testament at the time of our Lord Jesus Christ. No? Because you have the Old Testament scriptures, you should have understood what happened. Sabi ni Lord, ang hihina naman ng ano nyo, ng pananampalataya nyo. Ang sabi nun. And he says, even in John chapter 5, you know, do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one who accuses you, Moses, in whom you have set your hope. For if you believe Moses, you would believe me, for he wrote of me. You know? Yung sinulat ni Moses, ako yun, sabi ni Lord. You know? Ako yun. Pero ang hina yun, hindi nyo iniintindi, no? O inilalagay sa puso nyo ang pananampalataya tungkol sa isinulat ni Moses. Right? So, it's here in John chapter 5. Do not think I will accuse you to the Father. Hindi ako ang mag-aakusa sa inyo, kundi kung ano yung nasa scripture. It's not Moses himself, but kung ano yung isinulat ni Moses. Yan ang iharap sa inyo upang malaman nyo kung ano ang tama at mali. Like the Ten Commandments that Moses wrote in the book of Exodus. And he said, if you believe Moses, that means if you believe what was written in the Old Testament, in the scripture, you would believe me, for he wrote of me. But if you do not believe his writings, how will you believe my words? Ang sinasabi ni Lord. Moses wrote of you of what you are. Parang inaano nila, no? Ikaw, sinulat ni Moses. Do you mean we can go to the first five books of the Bible at maiintindihan namin ang rescue mission mo? Your redemptive plan? Do you mean that you are the Messiah? Pwede na, tanong na gano'n, no? It's precisely what our Lord Jesus Christ means. Redemption is not something of a second idea, of a second thought. No? It is something that we find in the pages of the Bible. In the pages of the Bible. Beginning from Genesis up to the book of Revelation. Lahat po ito, the central theme is our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? So, we don't go to the Bible, we go read the Bible for a like a fable, no? O para lang tayo nagbabasa ng mga educational books or newspaper or, you know, online Facebook mga accounts or something of story. It's not. No? Every little things, every details that are in the Bible are very important and somehow symbolizes who Christ is and His rescue plan. And the other thing, no? Minsan, pag nagpupunta tayo at binabasa ang Bible, No? We did not recognize the significance of the redemptive plan of God. Marami tayong narinig, no? That people somehow are teaching about psychology, teaching about how 10 things what to do. No? But you know what? We need to understand that the Bible is not just but a reference, but we need to see the redemptive plan of God in it. Yeah. So we need to examine the way we used to looking at and reading at the Old Testament and the New Testament or the Bible. As we want to see Christ as the redemptive glory in every pages, in every words that is in the Bible. Yun lang po ang pinakasentro, ang pinakabuod ng pagbabasa natin ng salita ng Diyos. Makita natin yung napakagandang plano ng Diyos sa atin. So, we want to go to the Old Testament, one of the main character in events that happen in the Old Testament. And this is not just a story, but events that happen in the life of Joseph. And Joseph is one of the sons of Jacob. Okay? So if we go to our title, God's Rescue Mission, we need to understand that God has a rescue mission, God has a redemptive plan for everyone. Okay? In Genesis 35, 23 to 26, we see the 12 sons of Jacob. Kung hindi nyo pa nababasa ang Old Testament at hindi nyo po alam na 12 po ang anak na lalaki ni Jacob, here it is. No? Sa apat na babae, the sons of Leah is Reuben, ang kanyang firstborn, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, and Zebulun. The sons of Rachel, Joseph, and Benjamin. Look at that. Joseph is in there, at ang kanyang mother is Rachel. The sons of Bilhah, Rachel's servants, is Dan and Naphtali. The sons of Zilpah is Leah's servant, Gad and Asher. These were the sons of Jacob who were born to him in Padan Aram, a place where God has brought him. So 12 sons of Jacob. 12 sons of Jacob. Joseph has already been, you know, when we go on and read chapter 37 of Genesis, Joseph has already been, have dreams, and even up to Genesis chapter 41, he has been in the pit. Yeah? Dahil sa kanyang dream, nagalit ang kanyang mga kapatid nung ikinuwento niya ito. No? When he told his dreams to his brothers, they hated him. They hated him. That's why he was thrown in the pit in Genesis 37. And he had been with Potiphar, who was one of Pharaoh's officials, as the captain of the guard, being a slave of Potiphar. But then Joseph was thrown into prison, falsely accused. No? Falsely accused, and he find his way later on in the royal palace. No? So he had been in the pit, thrown by his brothers. He had been with the Potiphar, a slave and servant. He had been thrown to prison, falsely accused, and he had been left out in prison for even more than 2 years. Ito po yung dinanas ni Joseph. Nakahirapan, no? Nakahirapan. It's very important that Joseph maintain his heart to be known that God is everything in happening to him are in God's plan. Okay? That's what I'm saying. Ang plano po ng Diyos, minsan nakikita natin, no? Parang yung pinagdadaanan natin ay puro pagsubok, kahirapan. Mga bagay na hindi natin maintindihan. But you know, if you know in your heart that God is saving you, God has a rescue plan, God has a rescue mission in you, no? Hindi ka bibitaw sa iyong pananampalataya sa ating Panginoon. So, it's very important that the dreams that Joseph had, it's stuck in his heart, no? Yung napanaginipan niya ngayon, no? And then two dreams. The first dream, when he went to his brothers to discuss that, who already hate him, ang iniisip niya, it's a good idea na sabihin niya sa mga kapatid niya yung napanaginipan niya. No? He told them about his dream, but basically, you know, after he told them his dream that later on, they will be bowing down to him, hindi yon naging kaaya-aya sa kanyang mga kapatid. And what they did, they threw him into a pit. And he had another dream, and now not only he told his brothers the other dream, he even told his father that went even worse. And after that, he was thrown into the pit. Okay? After being in the pit, eventually we see him in the prison. In prison, there's another pair of dreams, the baker and the cup bearer. Okay? One dreamt marvelously, the other is not so much. It is those two dreams that leads to his eventual release, although it took him additional of 2 more years. And now he stands before Pharaoh, who asked the interpretation of the 2 dreams that Pharaoh had, and he had to interpret it. Okay? So in the next verse, it says here in Genesis 41:16, Joseph answered Pharaoh, "It is not me. God will give Pharaoh a favorable answer." Look at that. No? Joseph recognized his limitations, and he recognized the power that the Almighty, that God can provide. So God will give Pharaoh a favorable answer. Ganun tayo dapat, no? Hindi tayo nagtitiwala sa kakayahan natin, sa kaalaman natin, sa karunungan natin. Dapat lahat ng bagay, even on major decisions in life, we need to bring this down to God. We need to ask the leading of God in our lives. It is very important. So Joseph said to Pharaoh, "It is not in me. God will give Pharaoh a favorable answer." So Pharaoh is asking him to, interpret his dreams. Ano ba ang dreams ni Pharaoh? There are 2 ears of corn, the helping ears, and the 6 ears, and the 7 sixths, and the 7 gobbled up the 7 healthy ears of corn. And there were 7 healthy cows, and the 7 sick cows, and the 7 sick cows were eaten up by the 7 healthy cows. And he looks at Pharaoh and he says, there are going to be 7 years of plenty followed by 7 years of famine. So store up during those years of plenty so that you have food to eat during the years of famine. So sabi ni Joseph kay Pharaoh, yung corn, yung ears ng corn, no? Merong good, merong bad. So kinain ng good, yung bad. Merong 7 healthy na baka at merong sakiting na baka. Kinain ng healthy baka yung sakiting baka. Right? So ibig sabihin nito, sabi ni Joseph in verse 25, the dreams of Pharaoh are one, God has revealed to Pharaoh what he is about to do. So magkakaroon ng famine sa Egypt. So it will take 7 years of plenty and then later on famine of 7 years. So, okay? If you are reading this in Genesis, no, you might come up with different ideas, no? Baka iniisip nyo na kailangan ito ay ika nga palakpakan natin si Joseph simula na ito ng kanyang pag-asenso. But you know what? It's kind of 50-50 kasi, you know, what happens next, no? We will show you as the verses mention. So, in Genesis 41:37-38, this proposal pleased Pharaoh and all his servants. Ano pong nangyari? And Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find a man like this in whom is the Spirit of God?" Ano pong nangyari? You know what? Pharaoh was just converted. Naniwala siya kay Joseph na yun nga ang mangyayari. No? And And even that, not only even that, Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find a man like this in whom is the Spirit of God?" So, ni-recognize niya ang kapangyarihan ng Diyos sa buhay ni Joseph. Sa buhay ni Joseph. So, and he said what he needs there is the revelation that comes from somewhere beyond human ability. Ni-recognize niya na hindi nila kaya. At walang tao sa Ehipto, magician man niya o mga tao niya na eksperto, hindi kaya na ganapin ang mga sinasabi ni Joseph to prepare for the famine. And the good thing is Pharaoh accepted the limitations of humans. Amen? Amen po ba? Ganon din dapat tayo. Paano natin ito maintindihan kung hindi natin binabasa sa Bible? Okay? The next slide says, "Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, 'Since God has shown you all this, there is none so discerning as and wise as you are.'" So, Pharaoh recognized God, the Spirit of God in the life of Joseph. At sinabi niya, "There is none so discerning and wise as you are. You shall be over my house." Then now, payback time. Yeah. Sabi ni Pharaoh, "You shall be over my house and all my people shall order themselves as you command. Only as regards the throne, I will be greater than you." No? All of a sudden, no? From pit to a slave to to a prisoner, now becomes a powerful man in the palace of the king or Pharaoh. Do you know Pharaoh thinks of himself as God? And yet, not at this time, he recognized the Spirit of God in Joseph. And yet, he will only be, Joseph will only be the second in command. The second in command. So, all of a sudden, he was put in the palace. Yeah? What's the next verse? Joseph is second in command to a pagan king. But you know what? All of a sudden, tandaan natin, Joseph, he has the Spirit of God because Joseph is part of the covenant of God to a family, to a community, to a nation. God has made a covenant with Abraham, who is the great-great-grandfather of Joseph. And the covenant he made with Abraham is not only on, is on the descendants of Abraham. So from Abraham, he begat, pinanganak niya si Isaac. Si Isaac begat Jacob, and Jacob begat the 12 sons, and Joseph is one of the 12 sons. Okay? So, look at that. So, Joseph is part of the covenant community. And yet, right now, what is happening is Joseph will be serving a pagan Pharaoh, a pagan king. Look at what happened here. And verse 43, "And he made him ride in his second chariot, and they called out before him, 'Bow the knee.' Thus he set him over all the land of Egypt." So lahat ng tao sa buong Ehipto, ibinigay ng Pharaoh na dapat na pagdarating si Joseph, hahawiin ng tao at ito ay luluhod sa harap niya. Verse 44, "Moreover, Pharaoh said to Joseph, 'I am Pharaoh, and without your consent, no one shall lift up hand or foot in the land of Egypt.'" Even ang immigration system sa Egypt, walang makapapasok, walang makalalabas, no? No? Without the consent, sa Egypt, without the consent of Joseph. Without the consent of Joseph. So he is the second in command to a pagan king. Yeah? And you know what? This is, in a sense, in a biblical term, this is blasphemous to our God. You know? Because Joseph is part of a covenant community. Yeah? And he is serving a pagan god. And what else? What else? It says here, then Pharaoh called Joseph's name Sephanat-Paneah. In verse 45, and he gave him a marriage, Asenath, the daughter of Potipherah, priest of On. So Joseph went out over the land of Egypt. No? So, ano pang nangyari? Moreover, Pharaoh said to Joseph, no? Una sinabi, I am Pharaoh, and without your consent, no one shall lift up hand or foot in all of the Egypt. And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Sephanat-Paneah. No? He not only served a pagan king, but he is also given a pagan name, a pagan identity. In fact, not only does Joseph have power, but he was also given great wealth. Yeah. Na-picture nyo ba kung anong nangyari kay Joseph? From pit to slave to prisoner to one of the second highest person in the whole, in the entire Egypt, next to Pharaoh. Next to Pharaoh. Okay? So far, what we have seen is a covenant man who belongs to the chosen generation of God is serving a pagan king. He has the pagan wealth and all the benefits of those power that is in him. And he's serving a pagan culture. And now he was given a pagan identity. Okay, so they got their name changed. He got a pagan identity, and he's serving a pagan king. Grabe, no? And in fact, in the story of in the book of Daniel, hindi lang si Joseph ang pinalitan ang pangalan. During the time of Daniel, Hananiah, and Mishael, and Azariah, no? They were brought, no, as captured by Babylon. They were exiled to Babylon by Nebuchadnezzar, and once they reached the palace of Nebuchadnezzar, they were given a pagan name. Why? Because they will be serving a pagan king. So Pharaoh gave Joseph also in marriage to Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, a priest of On. Okay? So just Joseph also went out over the land of Egypt. Yeah? Now, he got a pagan wife. So what did he get? Serving a pagan king, getting a pagan identity, getting a pagan wealth, having a pagan wife, serving a pagan land. Yeah? Pagan land. And you know what? He was, given all this wealth. And what is the reason? What is the reason? Okay. Let's move on. In verse 51. We find in, of course, starting in verse 50, before the year famine came, two sons were born to Joseph and Asenath. His pagan wife, the daughter of Potiphar, a priest of On. He got two sons who were born with Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, a priest of On. And Joseph called the name of the firstborn. This time around, hindi na siya pumayag na magiging pangalan ng kanyang mga anak would be pagan names. Yeah. He called his firstborn Manasseh, for he said, God has made me forget all my hardships and all my father's house. So, and then the name of the second son is Ephraim, for God has made me fruitful in the land of affliction. That's the translation. No? So, why Hebrew names? First, he did not give them Egyptian names. No? That means he is telling everyone, no, not to consider himself as an Egyptian. So he is declaring with the names given to his sons that he is a Hebrew, he is a member of a covenant people of God, that he is not one of them, the Egyptians, no? And you know what he gets are only a temporary, no? And look at the name of the firstborn. It says there, I've forgotten all my hardship and all my father's house. No? That means he forgot the things that he went through, no? That he went through, and it doesn't mean that he forgot his family. That means he forgot the hardship that he's been through and led him to the place in Egypt. So yun pong ibig sabihin nun. So the name Manasseh means I let that burden go. I let that burden go. Yung bigat ng hirap na pinagdaanan niya. No? He let it out. Tayo, no? Bago tayo nakarating sa mga kasalukuyan nating maayos na sitwasyon, marami tayong pinagdaanan sa buhay. Just like Joseph. No? Just like Joseph. But we are not defined by those things that we've gone through. No? But we are defined by the promise of God. The second name, the second born, named Ephraim. God has prospered me in the land of affliction. Nakuha niyo po ba yan? So Joseph says, Egypt is the land of his affliction. No? Hindi land of prosperity. Bakit kaya, no? Egypt is the land of affliction. Why? Because he is not what he was living for. Hindi siya tinawag upang magsilbi sa pagan king at mag-asawa ng babaeng pagano. No? At magkaroon ng mga ano doon sa lugar na iyon. He is declaring that I am the child of God. I'm one, a child, one of one true God. I'm the servant of the King of Kings or the servant of the King of Heavens. I don't exist to serve a pagan king. No? So, later on, no, of the story, he finally reveals himself to his brothers. Nung nagkaroon ng famine sa buong lugar at that time, his brothers came to Egypt without them knowing that it was Joseph. And then later, he revealed himself to his brothers. And he cannot control himself anymore. No? And what did Joseph did? What did Joseph do? Joseph says, God sent me here because God is a rescuer. Pinadala ako ng Diyos dito, no? Because God is our rescuer. God is our rescuer. Amen? Amen po ba? So, as we review what happened to Joseph based on God being the rescuer, God allowed these things to happen with Joseph. But do you know what? Going back to the promised seed, It is not with Joseph. If you look at Genesis chapter 4, let's go back to chapter 4. Okay, at the end of the chapter, I mean, it's almost on chapter 5, there is an announcement of the coming third son of Adam and Eve. Kasi what happened? The seed of the serpent, who is Cain, killed the seed of the woman, who is Abel, who was Abel. Kaya ang nangyari, you know, Adam and Eve had another son, and his name is Seth, to restore the godly seed. Kasi ang ginawa ni Satan, when he heard that the seed of the woman will crush his head, every time merong batang lalaki ay kanyang pinapatay. Just like what happened to Abel. What happened to Abel. So, if you look at chapter 5 of Genesis, you see the genealogy. There are 10 generations from Adam to Noah through the godly line of Seth. Yung isang anak na lalaki ni Adam. And God wipes out the world in the flood. And he preserved Noah, Shem, Ham, and Japheth, and their wives. No? And from there, the seed, the promised seed, continues. Okay, so the seed was promised, but still not in fruition. Tuloy-tuloy yung buhay. No? So eventually, God called a man named Abraham, who who is the son of Terah, and God makes a promise that that man, Abraham, will be involved in this promised seed. Yeah? And this promise is rather significant because he and his wife are too old for the seed. And yet, you know, God intervened in their life. Abraham, his old name Abraham became Abraham, you know, putting the name of God in the name of Abraham. And Sarai became Sarah, putting the name of God into Sarah. It is not only changing names, but God renewed their productive system. You know? Kaya, to make the story short, nanganak po si Abraham and Sarah, and their son's name is Isaac. So the promised seed continues. And Isaac begat Jacob and Esau, and Jacob begat the 12 sons. And one of them is the promised seed carrier. And who is this promised seed carrier? If you look at chapter 37, the story of Joseph stopped for a while. There is an interlude of chapter 38. The story is not about Joseph in Genesis chapter 38. It is about Judah, who is the promised seed carrier. The promised seed carrier. Okay? So, simula kay Judah, nagtuloy-tuloy ang lahing magdadala ng tagapagligtas. Okay? Judah goes on to have a son who is the great-great-great-grandson, and his name was David. That's why in Matthew chapter 1, if you look at the genealogy of our Lord Jesus Christ, beginning chapter verse 1 and 2, the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. And who is David? He is the great, 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 great grandson of Judah. Amen? And Abraham was the father of Isaac, verse 2, and Isaac the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Judah and his brothers. Amen? So even in the New Testament, it shows where the seed, the Messiah, was proclaim, you know? So, mind you, in conclusion, yeah, ano bang mahalaga sa atin? That God rescue us with all the things that are happening in our lives, o tayo lang mismo ang magre-rescue ng ating buhay? It's not, you know? We need to see the importance of knowing all these things through the Bible. God rescued Joseph in order to rescue Judah, in order to rescue Israel, and in order to rescue you and me. This is not about material wealth. This is not about anything else, but the rescue is about you and me to have that redemptive plan of God manifest in our life. No? It is about God in His mercy and grace orchestrating all of history in order to bring about that which we need and no one else, that is to be rescued by God. The first Adam ate and we all died with him or in him. The last Adam, which is our Lord Jesus Christ, died, and the result, we shall eat with him. So this is not about only Genesis, but it is about the whole of the Bible. Okay, it makes sense to see and know who the promised seed is, and that is the Messiah, our Lord Jesus Christ. So in Romans 8, 31 to 32, as I close, what shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? Who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all? How will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Ang Diyos po, no? Ang sabi ng Lord, no? Ang sabi sa Bible, no? What then shall we say to these things? Sa mga bagay na ito na ginawa ng Diyos. No? If God is for us, who can be against us? Who can be against us? Even the heaven's best, He gave it to us. No? The rescue mission, the redemptive plan of God. He gave what heaven had, the best that heaven has. And that is our Lord Jesus Christ. And He gave it graciously. Much more, yung mga ibang bagay na maliliit na bagay na kailangan natin ay ibibigay sa atin ng Diyos. So the mission is God rescue His people through His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And that is why, in connection with Matthew 28, no, there is a great commission. No? God's rescue mission, He is giving us great commission. Com means with, together. And mission means sending. So we are together with God for this rescue mission. And sabi ni Lord, no? Sa Matthew 28, and Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always to the end of age. So God's rescue mission, we are part of this mission. And that is why God is putting us to be commissioned. Sabi nga ron, com means together. Together with God, we are being sent to that mission of winning souls and making disciples. Kaibigan, kung sa oras na ito, ikaw ay nalilito, if you haven't experienced the love of God in your life, it's so basic to receive Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. We got here the ABCs of salvation. Yeah. ABCs of salvation. When we, for the first time, went into school as a kinder or grade one, this is the first things that we learn. Now, the numbers 1 to 10 and the alphabet, the ABC. So with salvation, this is the basic principle that we need to understand. Letter A, admit that you are a sinner. Lahat po tayo nagkasala. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Wala pong magsasabing wala siyang nagawang kasalanan. Lahat po tayo. We came from Adam. So the sinful nature is with us. Letter B, believe that Jesus paid for your sin on the cross. Believe. Manampalataya tayo na si Jesus ang nagbayad sa magitan ng kanyang mga dugo. Nagbayad ng ating kasalanan. And C, confess that Jesus is Lord and call upon Him for salvation. A, admit. Do you admit yourself that you are a sinner? And that's good. It's better to be honest than not. B, do you believe that Jesus paid for your sin on the cross? And C, you need to confess that Jesus is Lord and call upon Him for salvation. Would you like to do this? Saan ka man naroon? If you are in need, if you are in need of healing, if you are in need of reconciliation in the family, sa inyong mag-asawa, if you need blessings financially, materially, mentally, socially, physically, in the name of Jesus, if you need protection, God is calling you right now. Tinatawag ka ng Diyos. The Bible says in Romans 10, 9 to 10, that if you declare, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the mouth confession, when you believe in your heart, you will be saved. You will be saved. You know? So we need lives. Kailangan po natin ang Diyos sa ating buhay. Kaya, I want to help you. Hindi pa huli ang lahat habang tayo nabubuhay. I can help you in praying the prayer of salvation like this one. Yeah? Susunod po kayo as I read it, then you follow. Yeah? And then, hindi ko po kayo nakikita, and I may not know you personally, but you know, this is the best time to say this prayer na nanggagaling sa puso nyo, coming from your heart. And be sincere with your life. Be honest with your life. You are being seen by God. Now, I may not see what's in your heart, but God sees you right now. God sees your need. God sees your direction in life. Okay? So let us pray. Just close your eyes. If you can close your eyes. If not, then say this prayer that is coming from your heart. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sin. Please forgive me. Come into my life. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. I believe that I now receive your free gift of eternal life. Help me to live for you for the rest of my life. In your name, I pray. Amen and amen.